joining us here today on our V1 Kids homepage. Today we're going to start off with our first worship.
Megabyte? I knew that a red-headed troublemaker would strike someday. Luckily, I have something on standby.
Hey, V1 Kids, what's going on? Pastor Chad here, and I got my friend Emma. What's up, Emma? Hey, guys, we are here with you today because we want to talk to you about something really cool. Today, we are in a position where we're not actually being able to gather together at church as a family, but we're still doing what we do every weekend right here on V1Kids.com on Facebook. We would like you guys to stay connected with us here on V1 Kids. We are going to be able to talk to you about what's going on with the sermons and everything that God is doing in our church, in your lives, in our lives, as together as the body of Christ. Even though we're not together here at this church, just remember we're together in spirit. And just remember this, guys, that even though all the things that you're hearing right now that's going on with this virus, remember God is in control. He protects us. Psalms 91 says he's our shield, he's our cover, that he always guards his people. So today that brings us to our story that we were going to talk about. And I want you guys to get a hold of this, how we are talking about God as helper. That is just an amazing thing to be talking about in this time. And so I want to read the scripture for you right now. It's out of Matthew 8, and it's the story of Jesus and the leper. And then I'm going to hand it over to Miss Emma here, and she's going to kind of tell us about the story a little bit, okay? So Matthew 8, verse 1 says, when Jesus came down from the mountainside, large crowds followed him. A man with leprosy came and knelt before him and said, Lord, if you are willing, you can make me clean. Jesus reached out his hand and touched the man. I am willing, he said. Be clean. And immediately he was cleansed of his leprosy. What an amazing thing God did here. And you know what? Miss Emma here, she's going to talk to us a little bit and tell us. Emma, will you tell us a little bit about this story?
Sure. Well, hey guys, if you guys didn't know, leprosy was an awful disease where people got sores all over their arms and it was really miserable. If you got this sickness, you weren't allowed to be anywhere near people. And as the scripture says, whenever Jesus went through town, everybody followed him. It was like a crazy crowd. He was really popular. So for the leper man to reach Jesus, he had to break the law. What? Break the law is what you're probably saying. But yeah, the law said he couldn't be 5 feet within anyone else. So he had to push his way through that crowd, breaking the law. But he knew if he got to Jesus and Jesus was willing, he would be healed. So he thought it was worth it.
Wow. What an incredible story. Thank you, Emma. I mean, if you guys really think about this right now, this man, he was desperate. He had been like this for a long time. And you know what? He knew that Jesus, the Messiah, the Christ, was ready to heal him. You see, all it took was his faith. And he was willing, just as Jesus was willing. And all Jesus told him was what? Be clean. Be clean, he said. He gave those commands to that leprosy and said, be clean. And he was healed of that leprosy. And just like she pointed out, he didn't care what was going on around him. He needed a breakthrough. And that breakthrough was getting through the crowds. It was getting through the people, even though he knew it was against the law for him to do that. He just wanted an encounter with Jesus. He wanted to make sure that he met the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Maybe you're in that same position today. Maybe you've just kind of been feeling weary or feeling like a little sluggish and all this stuff going around about this virus and stuff like that. Remember, God is your helper. And remember, no matter what anybody says, we still need to take the proper precautions. We need to be clean. Make sure you're washing your hands all the time. Make sure you're sanitizing. And just remember that God, he takes care of us. But we need to take care of ourselves, just like this man did. He took care of himself in the sense that he did whatever it took to get to God. That's what we need to do. So I want to invite you today. If maybe this is the first time you're hearing about Jesus, we want to make a way for you because he's made a way. And that way is accepting him in your heart. That means he forgives you for your sins, all of your sins. He wipes them clean. Literally, it's like getting a big old chalkboard and writing all over it and then getting an eraser and completely erasing it. There's nothing there to see no more. Why? Because that's what Jesus does with our sins. But all you have to do is say, Lord, I accept you. So we're going to pray a prayer right now. And if you'd like to join us, that would be amazing. All you got to do is put your hand over your heart and just say this prayer with us. Father God, thank you for this day. And Jesus, thank you for dying for me. I am a sinner and I need saving. Please forgive me of all my sins. And Holy Spirit, fill me. Tell me what to do, because I'm all yours. I just want to live for you, God. In Jesus' name, amen. Wow, what an incredible thing. Welcome to the family of God. You know that the Bible says that the angels in heaven are rejoicing over one sinner who repents? That's you. God is so happy right now. Hey guys, just remember, as the week goes by and things come and go and you start hearing all this news, remember who your helper truly is. Pray to God. Ask him to help you through these seasons and these times of life. Through school, whatever it may be, he's there to help you out. We believe in you just like God believes in you. And just like this leper, he did everything he could to get to God. Do everything you can this week to get to God. And remember, he loves you, he's your helper, and he's all that you need. Hey guys, until next time, bless you. Hey Emma, thanks for helping us out this weekend.
Good having
you
here.
Amen. Bless you guys. We'll see you next week, okay? Bye.
Bye.
Hey guys, thanks for joining us today. We had an incredible time hearing about the big God story and what God is doing, not only in the Bible, but right now in present day. He is healing, I'm telling you guys right now. Hey, we want you to stay connected. So tell your parents or yourself, like the V1 Facebook page and stay connected with us. We wanna hear about you. We wanna hear comments, whatever it may be, but we would like and we would love to see more of you as we continue this throughout the next week. Hey, bless you. Let me pray for you real quick as we get ready to end our weekend and just say thank you to God for what he's doing. So Lord, we just say we love you and we praise you. Have your hand of protection upon your church, your people, Lord God. And right now, Lord God, we just pray that you are our helper, Lord. So thank you. It's in Jesus' name we pray these things. Amen. Hey guys, see you next time. Bless you.
All right, rolling and
beep. Take 257,651,405.
Get off the camera!
Oh my gosh!
You gotta focus, man, focus.
One.